நாராயணம் நமஸ்கிருத்ய நரம் சைவ நரோத்தமம் தேவீம் சரஸ்வதீம் வ்யாசம் ததோ ஜயமுதீரே கஜானனம் பூதகணாதிதேவிதம் கவித்தஜம்போ பலசாரபக்ஷிதம் உமாசுதம் ரோகவிநாசகாரணம் நமாமி விக்னேஸ்வர பாத பங்கஜம் ஆபதாமுபஹர்தாரம் தாதாரம் சர்வசம்பதாம் லோகாபிராமம் ஸ்ரீராமம் பூயோ பூயோ நமாம்யம் ஆர்தானாம் ஆர்த்திஹந்தாரம் பீதானாம் பயநாசனம் துஷதாம் காலதண்டம் தம் ராமச்சந்திரம் நமாம்யம் ராமாய ராமபத்ராய ராமச்சந்திராய வேதசே ரகுநாதாய நாதாய சீதாயாஹ பதயே நம பூஜந்தம் ராம ராமேதி மதுரம் மதுராட்சரம் ஆரோக்கிய கவிதா சாக்காம் வந்தே வால்மீகி கோகிலம் வால்மீகேர் முனிசிம்மஸ்ய கவிதாவனசாரிண ஷுண்வன் ராமகதாநாதம் கோனயாதி பராங்கதிம் கோஷ்பதீகதவாரீஷம் மஷகீகதராட்சதம் ராமாயண மாமாலா ரத்னம் வந்தே நிலாத்மஜம் அஞ்சனானந்தனம் வீரம் ஜானகீசோகநாசனம் கபேஷமக்ஷஹந்தாரம் வந்தே லங்காபயங்கரம் மங்கள பவன அமங்கள ஹாரி மங்கள பவன அமங்கள ஹாரி த்ரோ சுதசேரத் அஜிர விஹாரி த்ரோ சுதசேரத் அஜிர விஹாரி ஜெய 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 ஹனுமான் கோசாயி ஜெய 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 ஹனுமான் கோசாயி கிருபாகர குரு தேவகி நாய கிருபாகர குரு தேவகி நாய ஜெய 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 ஹனுமான் கோசாயி மங்கள பவன அமங்கள ஹாரி ஜனகசுதா ஜகஜனனி ஜானகி அதிசய பிரிய கருணாநிதானகி ஆகே ஜுகுபத கமல மனா ஜாசு கிருபா நிர்மல மதி பாமு விவர் இந்த உத்தரகாண்டம் ஆஃப் ஸ்ரீமத் வால்மீகி ராமாயணம் வேர் விவர் அட் த ஸ்டேஜ் வேர் ராமா இஸ் டெல்லிங் சம் ஸ்டோரிஸ் டு லக்ஷ்மணா ஹிம்செல்ஃப் Let's spend a moment or two in Vedanta, then we'll come into the story part. So there's an old philosophical question on or truth on the pot, the clay pot or the mud pot or the golden jewelry, the ornament made of gold. So is it So is it mud when it's a pot or it mud only when the pot breaks? Then only is it mud or is it mud already when it is a pot? Or is it gold when it is an ornament or only the ornament is melted it becomes gold? So stands to reason that it is mud even when it is a pot. It is gold when it is already ornament. So the question is, whether This entire creation is becomes Brahman upon dissolution, or is Brahman already? The difference is in the eye of the seer, the one who is knower, or the sage knows it to be Brahman. I know it to be the world. I cannot see the gold in the ornament. So if it is all Brahman, then let's put a question to ourselves. When we talk of discrimination in philosophy, which is viveka, we say that we must have viveka, right? We say that we must be able to discriminate between nitya and anitya, that which is eternal and that which is transitory, and hold the eternal and leave the transitory, right? Or have vairagyam towards the transitory. But if it is all Brahman, then what is nitya and what is anitya? It's a philosophical question that they put. So in our tradition they say, it is nitya only. It's called, one is pravaha nitya or pravahi nitya, other is kutastha nitya. One is, it's like the Ganges. Suppose you take the Ganga river. What is the Ganga river? It's a flowing river. So one drop of water, if you take, it's gone under the sea. Is that the Ganges, or what is the Ganges? So whatever I see as Ganges now, right from Gangotri up to the Ganga Sagar, 10 years later, not one of those water molecules is there in the Ganges. It's all new. The pravaha is still nitya. It's a very broad definition of elasticity, where you say, for example, even the human being or any creation or creatures, etc., we are all nitya, because you may go away, but your family line existed, it is coming out to you, it will go on. It's a pravaha, it's a going on and on. So when we have this plasticity of time, then sometime we will go into the stories of Yoga Vasishta, etc., but then everything can, then it becomes very different. Everything that's happening all the time is happening now. It could be happening now. So, but before we go further into that, why are we getting into all this? Is because we say, okay. If we take the Sri Vaishnavas, for example, for them they say Nitya Suris. They are the ones who serve the Lord in Vaikuntham. Vaikuntham, is it Nityam? It's Nityam. It's there. Kailasha is there. Saketa Loka is there. Goloka is there. These are all there. Sri Krishna is always playing somewhere, he is always in Rasleela somewhere, it's all Nitya Leela. It's a concept, it's a felt philosophical position taken by certain schools of philosophy. Now, coming back here. So we were on the September 1st date and we were talking about lot. That day was Rama, Rama, Rama and Rama. Ironically, the next day was Krishna Janmashtami, September 2nd. And when Krishna Janmashtami comes, it takes no prisoners. It just completely takes you. Krishna doesn't leave you room for anyone else on that day. From midnight till takes over. So that thought was in my mind, yeah, we completely missed Krishna that day. Krishna is tomorrow. None of us talked about Krishna. We were all so engrossed in Rama that Krishna we didn't mention. So in that context, I thought I'll share a few stories today which I had the good fortune of hearing from the discourse of Swami Akhandananda Saraswati of Vrindavan before I continue with the Uttara Kandam of Srimad Ramayana. So he says, there was a Mahatma in Vrindavan who used to tell a story that kind of distinguished between Rama and Krishna. Rama, as we all know, Maryada Purushottama. He is the guardian of the fortress of Dharma. He is a rock, Avarunachala. Maryada will not be transgressed. He is Shruti Setu Palaka. He is the one who guards the bounds of the Veda and the Dharma. He is the guardian of the virtue, system of virtues. So Sri Rama is Maryada Purushottama, Sri Krishna is Leela Purushottama. It's all Leela for Krishna. But then, we saw Adhyatma Ramayana. Sri Rama is Leela Purushottama. It's all is Leela. He makes the laws. In his own way, he is Leela Purushottama, and in his own way, Sri Krishna is Maryada Purushottama. In Mahabharata, you see, early morning, Sri Krishna gets up, does Sandhya Vandanam, does Agnihotra. Whatever role he plays, he'll play to the dharma of that role to the perfection. King means king, friend means friend, charioteer means charioteer. Whatever he does, he'll do correctly. The maryada of that role, he'll be played to perfection. स्वामी अखंडानंद सरस्वती से जी रसिया लोग हैं जिन्होंने अपने अपने गानों में अपने अपने भाव उन पे लगा दिए हैं. वैसे भगवान तो भगवान ही है. दिस पीपल दिस रसिकास और रस दोज हु लिव इन द जॉय ऑफ भावा है अप्लाइड देयर भावा ऑन श्री कृष्णा एंड ऑल दिस. That said, Bhagwan is Bhagwan. And it may be, some of you may be surprised to know that all this Krishna, Rasa, Leela, etc. was there. And in the middle centuries, it was applied for Rama as well. There is a whole bunch of stories of Rama, just like Sri Krishna, but it went away. I mean, it's not there now, but it was there. Now, but coming back here, we were talking about everything being real and now nitya, nitya, etc., right? So, he tells the story that his Mahatma and Vrindavan used to tell the story about Rama and Krishna, and Rama is, you know, he's from Saket Loka. Saket Loka is there. It's a nitya loka, always there. Dasaratha is there, Kausalya is there, Rama is there, everybody is there. Goloka, Nanda Baba is there, Yashoda is there, Krishna is there. They're there. All of them are there all the time. So one day, In Saket Loka, Kausalya decides. Long time I have not seen Yashoda. We haven't met. So queen, so she says, okay, let's go to Goloka. Let's go for an outing to Goloka, meet Yashoda, chat and come. Same time, in Goloka, Yashoda is thinking, long time I have not seen Kausalya. Should meet her. So both of them, independent of each other, they organize quickly all their, call their attendants and all that, and all the dasis and all, they come, they pack. Kausalya says, okay, I have to take this for Yashoda, she's not seen this, and I should take this. Yashoda is thinking, I should take some good butter from here, they won't get like this in Ayodhya. This thing, they are packing, each of them has packed a lot of things. For them, what is the problem? 100 caravans will come with them. No baggage allowance and all that. So they can just carry whatever they want, etc., and they can go. So they both, the morning, they set off in towards each other without knowing that they are like that. And of course, at that time, Rama is a small kid in Saket Loka, and in Goloka, Krishna is a small kid. So just as they start, Kausalya grabs her son and Krishna Yashoda grabs her son, both of them. They are all part of that caravan, enjoying. Elephants and camels and all coming here, all cows and all that. They are all coming towards each other. And they meet. Somewhere they suddenly, the two caravans meet each other. Divya Lokam, all about beautiful mountains, rivers, gardens, flowers, birds, deer, rabbits, this thing, general, good fun. They all meet, oh, you also, I also, and then they all sit down, they make camp immediately, they know, they quickly can set up camp. The picnic baskets come out, etc., they sit down and they start chatting. Yashoda and Kausalya, you have changed, like they're all talking to each other so much, enjoying. And these two kids, they're having fun, this Rama and Krishna. They're running here and there, they're having fun with each other, playing. And these mothers, they are chatting, mostly chatting about their children, you know what Rama did, what Krishna did. They're all chatting like that. Time passes, they eat lunch, they do, oh, that is nice, can I have that? Some special pickles he has brought. They're doing all that stuff. Suddenly it becomes evening time. So Kausalya realizes, evening, Dasaratha will be getting impatient. His dinner time is early and all that, so I have to go. And Yashoda says, I also have to go, this Nanda Baba is, he'll also be expecting now, we'll go, nice seeing you, etc. And they both decided to leave. And in that process, what happens is this, you know, the Kausalya, you know, she grabs Krishna and Yashoda grabs Rama. They didn't realize which the child is. So the kids get interchanged. So this goes off in that camp and that goes off in this camp and they go. They look very much absolutely like each other, except Krishna is slightly shade darker. Rama is slightly less dark, but they are exactly looking same, curly hair, everything is same height, everything. They can look the same if they want to, like that they are. They got interchanged. Now for the kids there is no problem because they have grown up with many mothers all the time, some ladies grabbing them, some mothers grabbing them. They don't know, this is my mother, that, etc. So many are there. And you know, somebody will take them. So it's not as if it's a major problem in their life that they've gone off. They go. They are all carefree kids, small Brahmins. They go. Now, what happens is that in Saketa Loka, Dasharatha is finished his Sandhya Vandana. Now, irrespective of whether his wife has come back from Saketa, from wherever she has gone or not, his dinner time is his dinner time. And he'll expect that she'll come and take care. So he sits down. He's got his plank. He sits down, his golden plate, etc. All cleaned with gobar, that place has been a nice place. He sits down, ready to eat. And thankfully, Kausalya's long time experience Dashrata lands in time, so that he can be served. And this Dashrata, no, he doesn't eat without Rama. They eat together. So he says, Rama, come, let's eat. This fellow is hungry, this Krishna, who's actually, he thinks is Rama, deadly hungry by this time. He's ravenously hungry. And Dasaratha says, come, let's eat. Oh, he runs to him. He jumps and sits on his lap. He doesn't wash his hands, feet, nothing. Simply runs. Goes and sits on his lap, and as soon as food is served, he grabs the food from Dasaratha's plate, starts eating, takes some, puts it into his mouth, Dasaratha's mouth. And Swamiji says, ye bachcha, isko sanskar hi nahi. He has no sanskar, he's not been trained, you know, he's a coward kid. Ahir ka bachcha. So he runs and he sits down. No washing hand, no food, nothing, no change of dress. He simply comes, sits down, grabs the food, puts it in his mouth. Swamiji says this, you know, talking of sanskara, he says, the shoes, they now have entered or conquered our houses. There's no place they don't go into. They enter the kitchen, they sit, come to the dining table, they're there everywhere. So he says, generally speaking, he's saying, like, for example, in a hospital, even the doctor has to leave the footwear outside before he goes into the ward, because he may bring something from the road which might affect the patient's health. In our house, we are much more lenient. We bring everything inside the house. Even in the dining table or kitchen, or doesn't matter. Anyway, coming back here. So this kid has come from somewhere. He doesn't wash his feet, nothing. He simply runs directly to his... He's not... sits down and starts. No, that's wonderstruck. In one day, this fellow's swabhava has changed so much. One day he has gone. He's come back changed, like this. Meanwhile, in Golokam, Nanda Baba is sitting for dinner. And he calls Krishna, Rama has come for to have dinner. In his place, Rama is there. So he says, come Rama, let's eat. And Rama says, I'll come. He goes, he washes his hands, he washes his feet, etc. Then he prays. Then he comes to Nanda Baba. Then Krishna and Nanda Baba eat from the same plate always. Whereas Rama is very confused when he comes there, he just stands there. Nanda Baba says, what happened? He says, where is my plate? Then he turns and asks attendants, get me a plate and get me a takat to sit down. So he is used to having his own wooden plank to sit and his own plate, and he'll sit next to Dasaratha and eat. He doesn't eat same plate and all that. He's a trained, he's got sanskar. So he sits down. Nanda Baba thought, this one day he spends with Ram, this fellow, and he's come back a dharmatma. Food was served. Started getting served. Rama waited for it to be fully served. Krishna had never waited for anything to be fully served. He waited fully served. And that had been served, then he purified it by sprinkling water, etc., then he ate. Meanwhile, that fellow was going. Krishna was in his full swing. By the time he had eaten, his stomach was getting filled, so he was getting more and more happy when he was sitting in Dasaratha's lap. Now he started doing all other pranks. He started pulling Dasaratha's mustache, his beard, taking some food and putting it into his mustache. He liked that. All that beard and all that he was seeing, big one. Nanda Baba never had that. So he put into that. Then he liked it so much, he got up and started clapping, running. Then he started dancing, it seemed. Nache. When he started dancing around Dasaratha, something is seriously wrong. Kya ho gaya Ram ko? He called Kaushalya, said, Kaushalya, come, what have you done, this kid? Kya ho gaya isko? Kaushalya said, what happened? He said, this kid, what is, look at. Then she came, she caught hold of this kid, and she looked. Then she said, gadbad ho gaya. Badal gaya. You know, these kids have got interchanged. This is not Rama, this is Krishna. Meanwhile, Yashoda also realized there, ki ye gadbad ho gaya. His kids have got interchanged. Now, this is a brief story. So Swamiji says, now you don't go around asking which Purana this episode has been described in. Which Ramayana this is there, or where does it come? Bhagavatam? Where is the proof? Where does it come? Point is, what is a katha? A katha is meant to convey some truth, some substance, some throw light on something. If you look at the etymology, that is the root of the word katha itself in Sanskrit, there is the commonly understood one which comes from kathanam, that is to say, katha. So a story which is said is katha. But the Vedic root of katha comes from katham, apparently. Like yatha, tatha, sarvatha, katha comes from similar such terms. So it comes from katham or kimartham or why. So katha answers the question why. How did it happen like this? If we instead focus on questions like where did it happen, when did it happen, which book has it been there, etc., we are missing the point in a katha. So Swamiji advises us that you leave those questions to the thesis writers. Thesis, wo apna kuch ulta palta nikal lenge. Whatever nobody has said before, if you say it, then that thesis is good.